And a leadership showdown is looming in the state after Premier Annastacia Palaszczuk announced she would retire from politics. A caucus meeting on Friday is set to decide who will lead Labor to the 2024 state election. For more, let's bring in now former Queensland Labor Minister Robert Schwarten. Rob, good morning to you. Less than a fortnight ago, Rob, you were calling for a leadership change in the Courier-Mail. You got your wish.
No, I didn't call for that. And if you read the article, what I said was I need to change the model. And that was obviously the Premier, and good on her, made up her mind to clear the path and for a new model to be created. But a new model is a lot more than just a leadership change. It has to be a direction change. And I never at any stage said that she should go. What I said was that the model wasn't working because where I live in Rockhampton, a solid Labor seat, people are turning off us because in that part of the world we've got two Liberal LNP, one Senator, one Federal Member who are belting the daylights out of us every day and convincing people that Labor never spends any money there, yet there's never been more money spent on infrastructure in central Queensland. So something had to give. And I just want to pay tribute to the Premier for her introspection, and it's a hard thing to do. She has had a look at it and she thought, no, well, I'm not the right person to go forward. But, you know, let's not forget what a great legacy she leaves. And she's taken us from the outhouse to the penthouse in the last 10 years and done a very good job. And as she said, she leaves a very good government. The job now is to get to the position where the people actually get to understand that again.
Well, whoever takes over has got a big job ahead of them. There is a housing crisis, a cost of living crisis. You've got youth crime to tackle as well in Queensland. Is a change of leadership going to be enough to help you win the next election?
I'm always amused by these sorts of crises. Do people really out there think that government is a cakewalk? I mean, in my time, it was a water crisis. It was a crisis of corruption, of a minister going to jail.
So you don't think that youth crime is at a crisis point in Queensland,
well,
or healthcare is at a crisis point?
No, I didn't say that. Don't put words in my mouth, mate. The reality is that I didn't say that there's always a crisis, is what I'm saying. What I'm saying to you is that that's what the job of government is to deal with these things. So it doesn't matter whether it's a youth crime. And by the way, I've been on your program before about youth crime, where our home has been robbed and whatever. So I'm not for one moment trying to downplay that. What I'm saying is it's the job of government to deal with those things. And this government has not turned its nose to it. It's actually working to try and solve it. But nowhere in the world has youth crime been solved. Let's get that straight. And Chris Fully saying that it will be is just a punk pack of the north end of a southbound bull.
Gotcha. I'm picking up what you're putting down. Tell me, who do you want to take over? Who's the best person for the job?
No, and again, if you read what I said, this is a job for the caucus. This is why caucus must function. And I am not going to, and I believe the rule is wrong where people like myself get a vote in the outskirts of the party. The caucus needs to make this decision. I know Stephen Miles, I know Veneman, I know Dick, I know the three of them quite well. It's not my job to pick out which is the best of them. History will tell you the deputies tend to do the apprenticeship to get up there. But I don't get a vote in this, and this is where caucus needs to stand up, and caucus needs to determine who it is as part of the change of the model, who it is that's going to be able to get there and sell their message, which is a very good message to sell. And my view is that they can turn it around. They've got 6 months to do it, and then another 4 months of campaigning or whatever the case may be. But it can be done because they've got a good foundation to start from.
We all know the polling's been bad recently, but you can't deny that Annastacia Palaszczuk has had an extraordinary innings as Premier, the longest-serving female leader in Australia, 9 years in government, 3 successful elections. It's quite a remarkable feat. How do you think Queenslanders will remember her?
Well, I think they'll remember her now for her gracious exit from the throne, dare I call it a throne. The reality is, look, I was there with Peter Beattie when he quit after, you know, around about the same amount of time. It's a tough job being the Premier of Queensland. I was a minister for 13 years, and the reality is that I run out of steam in the end of it. It's just a tough, mind-grinding, hard job, and I wish Annastacia Palaszczuk very well. History will treat her very well. As she said yesterday, she owed the Labor Party a lot, and she's never lost sight of that. So she's done a very, very good job, and And for all concerned, she has made a very brave and courageous decision, and she will be well remembered for that. History will record her appropriately as the best, well, not only the best, but the only person who has ever taken a Labor team from under 10 in numbers to a majority and stayed there for three terms.
Robert Schwarten, great to have you on today. We appreciate your time.
Always a pleasure. Thank you.
David. Very good morning to you at home. We begin this morning with the news that has shocked Queensland and the entire country. In fact, Annastacia Palaszczuk announcing her retirement from politics and exiting her role as leader of the Sunshine State.
Yeah, 9 years in the role. Many have been left asking what happens next. So in a moment, we're going to break down the coming days and what this is going to mean for Queenslanders. But first, a look back at the tenure of Annastacia Palaszczuk.
After months of leadership rumblings, Annastacia Palaszczuk calls time.
Standing up for the people of Queensland has been an honour of my life.
First elected to Parliament in 2006, taking over the Western Brisbane seat of Inala from her father Henry, Annastacia Palaszczuk would become the accidental Premier, going from opposition with just 7 seats to roll Campbell Newman at the 2015 election in one of the biggest political upsets this country has seen.
We begin a brand new chapter in Queensland's history. Thank you.
2 more election victories on, she cemented her place as a Labor legend and Australia's longest-serving female Premier. During COVID, the walls went up. So did her popularity. Palaszczuk resolute in maintaining Fortress Queensland. Among the highs, securing the Olympic Games.
Brisbane, Australia.
Though that's since been plagued by budget blowouts and fallouts.
We've already lost over a year when it comes to planning time for the Olympics.
In recent months, the Premier's popularity has also been in freefall, slammed over the youth crime crisis.
Come out, Anna!
Worsening housing woes and a buckling health system.
Queensland is in good shape, which is why now is time for me to leave.
Yeah, it took many by surprise yesterday. Let's go live now to Andrea Crothers. Andrea, good morning to you. Do we know who will take the top job?
Well, Sylvia, we should know come Friday. It could be a three-way tussle, though. The most likely contender will be Stephen Miles. He's the current Deputy Premier. He did receive the backing of Annastacia Palaszczuk yesterday. The other two who are weighing up their options, that's the Queensland Health Minister, Shannon Fentiman, as well as the Treasurer, Cameron Dick. Now, I want to bring in the State Opposition Leader, David Crisafulli. David, thanks for being here. Who would you rather go up against?
It doesn't matter. Our focus is on Queenslanders, and our focus has to be on the issues that they're talking to us about. The same people have been around the same cabinet table and have led to the mess that we're in. So we've got to focus on Queenslanders. We've got a health crisis, a housing crisis, a cost of living crisis, a youth crime crisis. That has to be our focus for Queenslanders, not who leads the Labor Party.
What do you make of this decision to do this during a cyclone?
Their priorities are wrong, and I'm not going to come here and trash the Premier today. The Premier has served the state for 9 years. That has to be acknowledged. But the way this has unfolded has left Queenslanders really uncomfortable. We've got youth crime running out of control. We've got a cyclone bearing down on the coast, people living out of tents, and the focus of 3 undermining ministers is to blow a Premier out of office. That doesn't sit comfortably with Queenslanders. It should have been Queenslanders who got a chance to have a say on that. Governments need to focus on Queenslanders, not on themselves.
Thanks very much for your time, David Crisafulli. Now, Sylvia, whoever does take on that top job, they'll have just over 10 months to rebuild and win back the support of the state ahead of the next election.
Andrea Crothers, thank you. Well-